For radio telephone operator Kyle White and the soldiers of Chosen Company 2nd Battalion Airborne, the mission to meet with village elders in the mountains of northeastern Afghanistan had red flags from the very start. They suspected the villagers of collusion with the enemy.
A lot of us, we had that, you know, just that gut feeling right before we left. It's just something wasn't right.
More alarms. It seemed like every male of fighting age and above was at the meeting. Radio communications were coming in a language the interpreter did not understand. And then when they left, the shooting started.
One, and then two shots, and then the echo, and then just fully automatic fire, and rocket-propelled grenades coming in from, seemed like, everywhere.
White was knocked unconscious. When he woke up, 10 of the 14 Americans in his unit were nowhere to be found. Among those White could see was Marine Sergeant Philip Box, by now severely wounded. White repeatedly braved enemy fire to drag Box to safety. Box later died, along with 5 other Americans. The Medal of Honor is being awarded to White for what he did to try to save his comrades and get them out of there, though he says he never expected to make it home himself.
I told myself from the beginning of that ambush that I was going to be killed. You know, just the amount of fire, I'm not going to make it through this.
But he did, along with Specialist Kane Schilling of Iowa, who says he owes his life to White.
I was probably more excited for it than he was, just because it shows, you know, he absolutely saved my life that day and many others.
Those who survived wear wristbands bearing the names of those who did not. White sees the Medal of Honor as a tribute to them.
To me, the heroes are those that lost their lives that day, because they gave their lives in defense of all of us and all of America.
Joe John, CNN, The White House.